This is CAT 2020 Quant Solutions. This is basically the slot 1 questions, part 3 of it. So we'll take 4 of the questions and look at how to solve in the best possible manner. So x equal to 4096 ratio of 7 plus 4 root 3, and we want 64. Now you need to be comfortable with powers of 2. So I know 64 is nothing but 2 ratio 6. I also know 2 ratio 10 is 1024. So 4096 becomes 2 ratio 12. So that means 2 ratio 12 is 4096, which is also nothing but 2 ratio 6 the whole square, or 64 square. So this is what I know. Now once I know this, I can substitute out here saying that x is equal to 64 square and then 7 plus 4 root 3. Now once you get this, we want to find 64, take it that side, other side. So 64 is equal to x upon 1, 2 into 7 plus 4 root 3. Now they are given all x ratio 7 in numerator. So I can rationalize the denominator. When you have 7 plus 4 root 3, you can multiply by 7 minus 4 root 3 into 7 minus 4 root 3. So this will become x raised to 7 minus 4 root 3 upon 2. Because 7 plus 4 root 3 into 7 minus 4 root 3, just to explain, is nothing but a square minus b square, which comes to 49 minus 48, which comes to 1. So that becomes 1. The denominator, 7 plus 4 root 3 into 7 minus 4 root 3 becomes 1. Now this is also nothing but x ratio 7 upon 2 minus 2 root 3. From the options you can make out, it will be x ratio 7 upon 2 upon x ratio 7 upon 2 raised to root 3, which is C option. So basically, first point relation between 64, 4096, which you can directly find out square. Once you get this, since you want 64, you can take everything on the other side and then try to find this normal rationalization of denominator calculation. If you can do that, you will get the answer quickly. The mean of 4-digit even natural numbers in the form of AABB. First 2 digits have to be same, the last 2 digits have to be same. And A has to be more than 0. So what can A take? If you look at AA, can take values either 2, 4, 6 and 8. And they'll be equal of all these numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8 will be repeated equal number of times. Right? A can take 2, 4, 6, 8. It can't take 0, remember that. And it can have equal frequency of 2, 4, 6 and 8. So average of this will be 5. So remember, arithmetic progression, the average is the middle number 5. So I know AA ka average is 5 and 5. What can B take? B can take value from 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, and there will be equal frequency of each of this. The average of these 5 is 4, the middle value. So B average will be 4 and 4. So directly you get the answer is 5, 5, 4, 4, A option. Straight away. Just take individual digits, take the average, you get the answer. So average of A, which is 2, 4, 6, 8 is 5. Average of B, which is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 is 4. You will get 5, 5, 4, 4. That will be the answer. So these methods normally help you to be fast. If you can do these methods, you will help you to be fast and you can actually solve all the questions in the examination. Actually, maths can make a huge difference in your score. So if you actually do well in your maths, you can almost score full in the examination, which will normally boost your score a lot. So people who normally score very high percentile are the ones who normally do very well in the con section. In terms of, they score a very, very high score in con. Okay, coming to next, the number of distinct real roots of the equation. If I take x, I'm just writing this down, you need not write all this in the exam. So x plus 1 upon x is y, so you get the equation as y square minus 3y plus 2. So if you look at the roots of this equation is y is equal to 1 and 2. That means x plus 1 upon x is 1 and x plus 1 upon x is 2. Now if you know it, or you can just try it out, just substitute value. The minimum value of x plus 1 upon x is 2. That is when x equal to 1. At all the other values, it's more than 2. So that means there's only one possible solution. So number of distinct solutions 1, that is x equal to 1 is the only possible solution. If you look at the minimum possible solution for x plus 1 upon x, I mean, just substitute and check out. I mean, if you take 1, you get 2. Any other value substitute, you get more than 2. So from that, you can make out the answer has to be x equal to 1, because that's the only thing that will satisfy you. The first case, nothing will satisfy. So one solution, that will be the answer. Person spend 50,000 on purchase of desktop computer and laptop computer. This, if you look at average, is given to you 2% profit. So average is given to you, you can use allegation. 20% average profit, 10% loss, that is minus 10%, gives you average of 2% profit. If you just do allegation, so automatically you get this 12, you will get this as 18, you will get a ratio as 2:3. 2 and 3 put together is 5. 5 stands for 50,000. Okay, so we want the price of the desktop is, okay. So desktop was the one with 20% profit. Laptop was the one with 10% loss. So desktop is the first one. It'll be 20,000. So 5 into 10,000 gives you 50,000, or 5 is 50,000. So 2 will be 20,000 as a desktop. So we'll get the answer as 20,000. So be comfortable with allegation. It normally helps in all the exams. It normally helps to be fast. If you can know allegation, some of the, and this can be solved mentally also. If you do allegation mentally, you get a ratio 2:3. From that, you directly get 20,000 as the answer. Small tricks helps you to be fast. Know it, and that's what how you improve your speed. Thank you.